Hello everyone. I hope you all are learning well. And first of all, thank you all for liking my work and appreciating it. It really motivates me to continue to work and put more effort. So that's not my daily job. So I do this after my work as, you know, in free time as my hobby. And also I like it. So I am not a very expert in deep learning, just a learner and practitioner like you guys. And I'm trying to explore neural networks. And so exploring neurons, it's pretty cool. And yeah, I was thinking this for quite a time to come up with a tutorial series. And so this is the episode 0 of this tutorial series called TFK Deep Learning, where I'll be trying to implement the deep learning networks, the models, using TensorFlow and a combination of both TensorFlow and Keras. So as we progress through this series, we'll see how we implement all the networks in these two approaches. So let's get started with episode 0. So you know, everything whatever we are doing, either in machine learning, deep learning, or other techniques, it's all a child of a tree called artificial intelligence. So our ultimate quest is to achieve the goal of artificial intelligence, that is giving the ability to computers and machines to mimic the cognition and behavior as humans. From there came machine learning, where the techniques which gives ability to the computers to learn of their own without being explicitly programmed. And deep learning is another subset of machine learning, which comprises mainly of neural networks and some cool techniques and some other methods, which like gives better, you know what, let's say better chance of, you know, learning from more data and, you know, generalizing to more stuff. So let's go to next slide and see more about deep learning. So, you know, deep learning is a deep structured learning or hierarchical learning. It's called hierarchical learning because it learns hierarchy of features, and it is inspired by our brain, where even in our brain, if you have seen other videos or papers like the visual cortex or cortices, they learn, you know, any features in hierarchy. So in the lower level, you know, we learn lower level features, like in this case, edges. And then next level, we'll learn some simple shapes like a triangle or, you know, L shape or circle, anything. And from there, we'll learn some complex shape like, you know, honeycomb structure and wheels, etc. So it's a hierarchical learning, and deep learning is end-to-end learning, which means we just give input and at the end, we get our application. And it is a generic, like it can be, these techniques can be implemented to different tasks and different application. It is not domain specific, and so it opens a lot of opportunities to explore and research in this area. So sorry for that. So you can implement it in images, in audios and text, and get, you know, all this application, you know. Okay, so said that, how we are going to implement this deep learning, we'll need some library. And as of now, TensorFlow is a really popular library. It's an open source library provided by Google, and it has a C++ backend. That's why it's quite faster. It provides both C++ and Python API, but, you know, Python API is really easy to use, and also provide Keras API with the release of Keras 2. We can deploy this TensorFlow models on CPUs or multiple GPUs, distributed GPUs in desktop, server, or even mobile devices. And obviously it has a very easy and clean interface, and it has number of good features like tensor board and checkpoints, where you can visualize, you know, your embeddings, your graph, loss graph, accuracy graph. We'll look into that later. And everything in TensorFlow is defined within a structure called data flow graph. So this is a data flow graph where all the networks or all the models will be, you know, within one graph. And they'll be like described, all the elements will describe with some nodes, and all the data will be flowing between these nodes or operations. So it's really cool structure, and we'll look into it when we implement it. And using TensorFlow, basically you can implement any model or any network from scratch. Okay, so this is a tweet of August 19, just 2 months ago, and it shows, you know, among the researchers, TensorFlow is really the most popular one. And it is TensorBoard, where we can visualize, you know, histograms, the images, the embeddings, the laws, the learning, and everything. And then the Keras. Keras is like my favorite. It's really very easy to use, very modular, and it's really cool, you know. I mainly work on that. It has a backend of TensorFlow, Theano, and CNTK. And with release of Keras 2, you know, TensorFlow is kind of built in Keras 2. And this is a slide which I took from this submit in Feb 2017. TensorFlow Development Summit. I'll provide the link. You can have a look at this lecture. It's really cool. So it says TensorFlow Keras built on top of core TensorFlow features. We can easily mix and match pure TensorFlow and Keras functionality. And with TensorFlow, Keras users can gain access to distributed training, cloud ML, and hyperparameter tuning, TF serving, and so many things. So you can have a look at that lecture. And one more thing, like if you want to learn Keras, you know, this blog is really good, Stepwise from Scratch by Jason Brownie. It's a machine learning mastery. So we'll implement our networks in TensorFlow, and also we'll mix TensorFlow and Keras, where we'll be using TensorFlow as platform and Keras as API. So, you know, there are different type of learning, like supervised, semi-supervised, unsupervised, reinforcement. And, you know, supervised with regression classification, and unsupervised we have clustering, density estimation, dimensionality reduction. So initially we'll be implementing all the supervised learning networks, and on later, depending on the time and resources, I'll try to make videos on unsupervised or reinforcement learning. Okay, said that. So let's see what is this tutorial series about. So this is about implementing the concept of deep learning networks like linear logistic regression, deep neural networks, CNNs, RNNs, long short-term memory, multimodal networks, GAN, Siamese network, and many more. As I implement, I will learn myself, and I'll share with you guys. And then I'll try to cover the applications of object recognition, object detection, video recognition, text classification generation, image generation, visual question answering, and many more. It will come. So this course is about implementing the neural network from scratch using TensorFlow, and then mixing TensorFlow and Keras, as I said earlier. So anybody can follow this tutorial who knows the theory and they're trying to, you know, implement and getting started with deep learning. Any models, because I'll try to cover most of the models, or intermediate level practitioners. And if you're familiar with Python, it will be really helpful for you, because everything will be in Python. And if you are familiar with the theories, then it's really great. So the approach we are going to follow for this tutorial series, we'll first look into the basic theoretical concept of any network that we'll be implementing. And then we'll try to implement that network in TensorFlow. And then the same network we'll try to implement with Keras API, because that will be much easier. So we'll see as we implement how this both TensorFlow and Keras work out for us. And the environment I'm going to use for implementing any of the models or neural networks, I'll be using Python language, obviously. It's really cool. And I'm going to use TensorFlow library, as I've discussed earlier, and the Keras library. So this Python and TensorFlow and Keras will be what we'll be using to develop our neural network model. And that's all from episode 0, and tune into episode 1 to get a very detailed introduction about neural network and deep learning, starting from what is AI, what is machine learning, deep learning, and how neural network works and everything. And till then, keep learning, keep exploring neurons. And if you like the videos, then hit the like button. If you have anything, you can comment below. And if you want to get notified, you can subscribe to my channel. And if you'd like to support me, you can support me on Patreon and PayPal. The links will be given below. Thank you. Bye.